one more, VA 2022-15.
Save the more interesting one for last.
Oh, great.
This one is also a rezoning request for 11 different parcels that comprise about 7.1 acres. To rezone from accommodation of R6 and R10 to all RM, which is multifamily residential. This is part of a proposed partial neighborhood buyout to convert these 11 single-family homes and their sites into a planned apartment complex. In your packet is a copy of a conceptual site plan that shows the nature of the buildings. I think the plan calls for 124 apartments, which is a little bit under the maximum density that RM would otherwise allow. As you know, with multifamily development, it's not just number of units per acre, but they have to also get parking and other required site features to fit. So the zoning pattern you see on the map of your packet is on the screen. You see the mixed pattern. There's a little bit of history to that, which I've given you in the packet. Back, I think it was 2007, there was a different proposal for neighborhood buyout for conversion to apartments. There was a little bit less of a site plan with that. And it also included the RM property you see to the north, which became what was for many years called the College Station Apartments. It's now called the Gates. That was part of that proposal. That is the part that was developed as multifamily and RM. This was back before the LDR came along. Back in those days, R6 zoning was the multi-county zoning district. What became College Station was zoned R6 at that time, and that's where how it was developed. In 2009, the rules changed. R6 went from a multi-family zoning district to allow houses, duplexes, or apartments, to just one that allows houses or duplexes. The RM zoning district was created with the LDR, and that was the multi-family zoning district. What happened in 2009, when the LDR was adopted, there was no new zoning then. So all of the existing larger apartment complexes in the city that were zoned R6, they all became non-conforming. 5 months after the adoption, staff realized what had happened and went through and identified all of these apartment complexes. The city initiated rezoning of all of them from R6 to RM. The College Station was developed, so it was part of that list. The remaining R6 properties south of here, which were part of that rezoning request, were left out because they had not been developed as apartments. And as you look on the pattern on the map, the geography was a little bit problematic. Some of the properties did not agree to that rezoning in 07, so they remained as R10. So now we come forward to 2022, different developer, wanting to continue that idea of what was started in 07 and then recombine this one area behind the existing apartments and as a neighborhood buyout. And unlike previously, they've got the consent of all of those property owners. Those letters of authorization are in your packet. So this one is a stronger proposal than 07, but it essentially repeats what was done in 07, but simply includes a few more properties that are 10 now, that didn't go along with the proposal back in 07. Lots of discussions about this. We've had many inquiries over the years of folks wanting to convert smaller portions of this to apartments, and smaller portions, i.e. in a piecemeal fashion, I'm very much opposed to. But what they are proposing is this whole compact area of the neighborhood to go to multifamily. It is bordered by multifamily on two sides. It's adjacent to the BSU campus. It's a very good location for multifamily in the area without really disturbing into the middle of the neighborhood, the building onto what has already been transitioned from single family to multifamily. So you see the zoning patterns, character area, transitional neighborhood. We've been talking a lot about that. This is one of those areas where the neighborhood is transitioning to higher density. Aerial imagery, you see the existing apartments to the north. That used to be houses, just like the subject property 15 years ago. And then you see the tree cover. And then the large area to the south, that is VSU campus property on the other side of the 2 Mile Branch. What you don't see a little bit beyond that is some of the VSU facilities, including athletic do not see the multi-purpose trail that follows the creek. The applicants are looking at trying to connect physically to that trail, which gives them a good direct connection to the campus. Again, all part of some good design. Survey shows the different properties and their acreages. One thing you might notice is the street on the southerly part that runs south of the Bay Tree Drive. That is part of Airmar Street. Applicants proposing to vacate and close that road so it becomes part of it. That is a dead end right of way that fades into the south toward the jungle before you even reach the creek. It is not needed as a road, and so I think predicting that vacation will probably go through. And what that does is facilitate the applicant site planning instead of the packet. It's better illustrated by the other drawing in the packet that shows the different colors for the different buildings. Interestingly, not all the buildings are the same. Some are two-story, one-story, or three-story. And as appropriate, the taller, more dense buildings were in the southern part of this area, further away from the single-family neighborhood, which I think is also good design. Subject properties, there are a lot of them. I did not put photographs of all, but just a very good example. Single-family residents in this area, many of which are rental properties, but not all. And some of them you could almost tell by driving down the street. Adjacent properties, this is the view from the intersection of Bay Tree Drive and Wainwright. This is on the west side of the subject property. This is looking south downhill toward the creek. This you kind of see the edge of the neighborhood with the subject property. Looking northward from that intersection, the lot on the immediate right is part of the subject property. It's that northwestern lot. But beyond that is the single-family neighborhood to remain. And then around the corners, you get view of the old College Station, now called the Gates, where it is up against the existing neighborhood. This is the other multifamily in the east of the subject property. And then that view looking northward toward Bay Tree Road, where you already see multifamily in place. And then the entrance into the apartment complex that is there. So with all of that, staff has found the request consistent with the comprehensive plan. The stands for exercise of zoning power. Those detailed responses are there in your packet. And we're recommending approval of the change of 72RN as proposed. Is there a question you may have?
Any questions? All right, if not, let's open it up to the public. Is there anyone out here tonight who would like to speak on behalf of this request? You will give us your name and address, please.
My name is Bill Kent. I'm with Innovate Engineering, 2214 North Patterson. We'll be the civil engineers on the job. Don't have a whole lot more to add than what staff, other than the road closure. Today found out that the petition has been approved. It's moving forward. The public notice will be starting. The advertising will be this weekend and be heard before City Council on the 22nd.
And that's just the southern portion of Miramar.
That's right. Okay. And as always, all development regulations will have to be adhered to. We do have some floodplain issues to deal with, which we will. Water and sewer is available. The traffic, as was stated, this being so close to BSU, these developers somewhat specialize in student housing, so their desire is for mostly pedestrian or walking and bicycle traffic. But for those, you know, we do have multiple streets that can be accessed to get to Bay Tree and to Melody Lane, and back around to Gordon Street eventually. So we got good traffic flow there. We discussed this with all of the departments of the city. So
I think it's a good plan. Good use of the dirt.
Well, the layout is pretty good. So.
Wonder who did that.
You glad to answer any questions?
Any questions for our speaker? All right, thank you, Bill. All right, is there anyone else tonight who would like to speak on behalf of this request?
I'm Matt King, 3314 Bellamy Drive. I'm the owner and general contractor of the Crown Group. I'll be the builder on this. I developed multiple multifamily projects in my office. So I'm basically here to answer any architectural questions you might have on the building's exterior.
Questions? All right, thank you, Matt. All right, is there anyone else who would like to speak on behalf? All right, is there anyone who would like to speak against this request? If you'll come forward, please. Anyone wishing to speak against this request? All right. Oh, sorry.
My name is Catherine Mayer. I live at 924 Regional Drive, which is at the top of the Wainwright Hill, which is in the more expanded neighborhood of this proposed development. And I wouldn't necessarily say I'm speaking against it, but I definitely have concerns. I watched what happened on Mary Street when it was approved for them to have two apartment complexes there and a VSU field house. And every day now, you just about can't get down Mary Street because of all the cars that are parked because VSU doesn't have enough parking. And for some strange reason, it's legal to park in the traffic lanes on Mary Street. So having been through that, in other words, that's part of the background of my concern, because I'm not totally convinced that this is going to be a good thing for the neighborhood I live in. We have all residential houses at the top of the hill and in the area, you know, around where this is proposed. There already are some apartment complexes, as you know, that are a little bit closer to Bedford Road. And when they made one of those, they closed the street. Now we're going to close another street. So this means there actually is less access out of my neighborhood to the main roads, like Jerry Jones and Baytree. And I don't know how much traffic there's going to be with these new apartment complexes, but this is a pretty big chunk of land. And I'd like to be convinced that, one, there's going to be adequate parking. Because just because they're college students doesn't mean they don't have cars, because all those football players at the field house can't walk to the field house. They got to park their vehicles on the right of way of the road. And I was told that that's legal for them to do that, which I don't understand. So I'm concerned about the traffic. I'm concerned about the parking. I'm concerned about another street closure, which actually means there's kind of like less access out of my neighborhood to the main part. And then all the people living in the apartments, you know, are going to be wanting to get out of the neighborhood and everything too. So anyway, I do have concerns. And I had concerns on Mary Street, and I've got our record on those, and everything just got really changed, and that's where we are now. So I don't see that happen in my neighborhood again on the other section, because Mary Street's in my neighborhood, this is in my neighborhood. And there are problems, and there are problems I was concerned about before it ever happened, and they're real now, and everybody's ignoring it.
All right.
Except those of us that have to get up and down Mary Street.
All right, is there anyone else who would like to speak against this request? All right, there being none, I'll turn it back over to the commissioners. Any further discussion or questions for staff?
Parking, you know, it is a problem on Mary Street, and have they considered extra parking and stuff for these kids?
Well, the parking standard for apartments has changed. Years ago, it used to be just a flat two parking spaces per unit. Now it's one parking space per bedroom is the minimum. So the larger apartments require more parking. So they've got to get involved with it. I just made a note to myself to look at the Mary Street to see if there's some illegal parking going on. Or if there is, then some powers that be need to know how.
Just echo what she said about the parking on Mary Street around the football field. Emergency vehicles cannot get through there if they price it. And they come around and put the sign that said no parking around the field, and you got people parking everywhere around there.
So it's athletic field parking that's open to the street?
Yes.
It's the field house, isn't it?
It's the Pikes the Field House. And it's soccer field, which is together
there. And that's not a very big parking lot.
Yeah. And, plus, a spectator that, you know, watches them. Is this a problem with the parking around Mayberry?
All right. Any other discussion? All right, I'll ask for a motion, please.
Madam Chair, regarding VA 2022-15, a request to rezone 7.13 acres, currently zoned R6 and R10, the entire tract moving to RM. Per staff's recommendation, I move that we recommend approval to the Valdosta City Council.
All right, we have a motion to approve. Do I have a second?
I'll second.
All right, is there any discussion on this motion? All right, all those in favor of the motion to approve, please raise your right hand. And all those against, and the motion carries.